All right, today we're gonna go through my catch surf quiver. I've been getting some requests online all over the place. I figure I should give you a play-by-play on every single one of these boards. All right, so we're gonna jump into the smallest board of them all, the catch surf Womper. This board is absolutely amazing. I can promise you, this board goes everywhere I go around the world. It is the perfect board for always getting barreled. No matter how big or how small the waves are, this board always fits in the barrel. Like if the barrel's like this, you can get a barrel like that big. Like this board is the board. All right, next up, we got the classic Pro Boogie Board. Board's amazing. Got some crazy waves on this board at the wedge, scooping some epic drops. Really wanted a boogie board in my quiver. I like boogie boarding, it's super fun. Some people say it's boogie boarding, I call it bodyboarding. Whatever it's called, this board's epic. From sand sliding to getting super sick barrels at Keiki Shore Break to taking it to the wedge, this is kind of an all-around boogie board. I even get involved at Waimea Shore Break. There's just something about you have to have a boogie board. All right, next up, we got the Catch Surf Beater. This board was invented for the black ball in California. They put up a flag. They say you can only ride a board under a certain amount of inches, and this was the beater. They beat the black ball. This board's epic, amazing. Took me a while to understand what this board was all about. There's some really cool concave on the rails. That way when you're doing 360s on it without no fins, it doesn't really catch a rail too bad. It has an option for a twin fin setup right here. I don't really get involved with a twin fin setup. I absolutely love this board for finless surfing. Done some of the craziest stuff I've ever done in my life. And it smells brand new. This board is so epic. If you're just getting into the beater, the whole vibe, start with the fins and slowly but surely work your way to no fins. This board is an epic sand slider. This board is an epic board to do a lot of 360s. My advice, my pro tip to you is stay low and stay engaged on your rails. Put your back foot really close to this edge right here, and then the front foot just nice and in the middle, and stay low and just start spinning 360s. Five, two, J-O-B, Pro. Let's see if this works. Oh, that was pretty sick. All right, so I designed this board with Catch Surf a few years ago. I wanted something a little more progressive, a little more fun, and a little more fuller. So I'm a little bit of a bigger dude, This board has some really nice volume in it. It is probably the most rippable catch surf board I've ever owned in my life. I remember when I was doing testing for this board before it even came out, I was like, hey, honestly, this is the best board I ever rode. Some really cool features about this board. It is nice and wide. It is a 5.2 and there's a 5-fin setup here. So you could ride this board as a twin fin, you could ride this board as a quad, or you could ride this board as a thruster. So you have plenty of options. This is kind of like one of those things. If you're gonna buy a board and you're confused and you're not sure what board to buy in the Catch Surf Quiver, buy this board because you have so many options in the fins and it's an amazing board. This board turns really nice and it rides the barrel really epic, paddles you into pretty much anything, and that's a win-win. All right, so next up we have the 5.8 JOB Pro. This board is the big brother of the 5.2 JOB Pro. So what I really like about this board is when the waves are getting a little bit bigger, you know, and the head high to little overhead, even a little more overhead, this board is great. It's got some good buoyancy. It's got a little extra length on it. And that's what I really like about this board is that when Keiki shore break or the shore break you prefer to surf is a little bit bigger and you're having a hard time making the drop, sometimes it's a better idea to ride a little bit bigger of a board. And that's why I added this board to my quiver. It was very important to me to have a board that was a quad because quad fins are actually faster. So in pulling in the shore breaks, once I got into the barrel, I started moving twice as fast. Quad setup's fun. You could ride this board as a twin fin as well. Some crazy concave in here to help you with turning and speed. Beast mode board, love it, epic, catch surf. Surf 6.0 Log. This board is straight up amazing. I love this board. The volume in this board, just equivalent to like a board you'd ride at Jaws. That's how good this board paddles. So if you're a heavier set dude, or you're just some little grom that just wants to go shred and catch every single wave on the planet of Earth, this board is an amazing board. I've used this board at massive YMS shore break. I've used this board at Keiki's. I've used this board at Pipe, Backdoor. I've even got some crazy waves at the wedge on this board.
Okay.
All right, so we saved the best board for last, the Catch Surf J-O-B 9-foot log, this board. I'm not even like gonna just sit here and not tell you this is the best board in the world. This is the best board in the world. Massive pipeline pit, massive back door, massive off the wall, massive jaws, massive wedge, massive, massive. I love this board. This board, you know, you could take to Waikiki and go surfing with your girlfriend and just have a absolute blast. If it hits you in the head, it kind of hurts, but it's not that bad. And it's got a thruster setup. Thruster setup is ideal for pipeline. So people always ask me, are you riding the same fins that you bought the board with? Yes, I am. And what I do here is I get those same fins and I crank these guys down before every surf session. And this helps engage the fins. Thank you for checking out my Catch Surf Quiver. These boards are amazing. I appreciate you guys, and I'll see you in the water, psyching out of my mind. Let's go!